Every analysis that we do using IBM SPSS statistics software involves data. But unless you are always collecting your own data, you are sure to run into data sets that are not structured the way that you need them to be. Fortunately, SPSS gives us some powerful tools to modify data structures. We're going to dive deeper into modifying data in SPSS to get them ready to analyze. So sometimes you have a continuous scale variable like age, and you need to create age bands. So for this example, we're working with a grant, and the grant funder uses the same age formatting for all reporting in all of their grants. So we have been asked that we report the ages of our participants in these specific bands. Now, wisely, we have asked for the participants' actual age on our survey. So now we can create custom age bands and we can still keep our original data. So for this example, we will continue using the demo.sav dataset that comes with SPSS. To create our age bands, go to Transform, Recode into Different Variables. Now we are creating a new variable that will leave our original age variable intact, but calculate a second variable with the age bands that we need. We begin by moving our age variable into the variables box. The question mark tells us that we need to add some more information. We will name our new variable AgeCat, and we will add a label Age Categories. Click Change. Now we are ready to adjust our old and new values. We identify our old values over here, and then we tell SPSS how to change them in this box. Our first age band is those under age 21, anyone from 0 to 21 years old. So we can use the range lowest through value. Anything lower than 21 will be coded as a 1. Click Add. Next, we will create some ranges. So we want a range from 21 to 40. Before the range, we type 21 and 40 and add. Now here we see that we have a problem. We have a 21 in both ranges. Whenever you create categories, there can be no overlap in the categories. For this example, each person's age should fit in only one bin. And we can fix this by editing the first age range. Click on the band and see that it recalls the settings. Because the band is under 21, we will make the value 20.99 and click Change. Now, we probably could have used the lowest through 20 because we have whole numbers as ages, but this way is even more precise and it gave me the opportunity to teach you a new skill. We can add another range of 41 through 64. We will code this range as a 3 and add. For those ages 65 and older, we'll use the range value through highest. This will take any value from 65 through the highest number in the data set, regardless of what it is, and click Add. Now let's assume that we have some missing values in our data set. How would we code those? We will create a new category for people who did not provide an answer. Any system missing values, any missing data, will be coded as a 5. And later, we can label 5 as no answer. We are done recoding this variable, so you can click Continue, and then you can click OK. In Variable View, we can now add value labels to each of the levels of our new variable. We will make the value of 1 equal to under age 21. The value of 2 will be age 21 to 40. The value of 3 is age 41 to 64. The value of 4 is age 65 and over. And remember, we created one more level, so we will code a 5 as no answer. Let's check out our original and our new variables. Right-click on age and choose descriptive statistics. Now click on our new variable, age cat. Right-click and choose descriptive statistics. We see the descriptive statistics and a frequency table for the age bands.